Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to be explaining the basics of scenes in JavaFX, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Well, hello friends, this video is all about scenes. A scene is a drawing surface for graphical content and a container for nodes. During the last video, we covered the architecture of an FX GUI program. I like to think of it as a sandwich, the stage is the bread, the scene is the meat, and all of the nodes are various toppings and condiments. We covered stages in the previous video, and in this video, we'll be focusing on scenes. Before we begin, let's just make sure we have a few things set up. So, with all of our imports, you can import things as you're going along, but you'll want to be sure that you're importing from JavaFX and not any place else. Otherwise, a lot of the stuff might not work. So, we need a root node. I'm using the group class to create a root node, add the root node to the scene. You can create a stage, or you can use the stage that is passed in via the start method, add your scene to the stage using the set scene method, and at the end, show the stage. You'll be ready once you run the program and you have a blank scene on a stage. Now, to create a scene, we need to pass in at least a root node, but we can add a few other things as arguments too when we construct a scene. We can add a width and a height for the scene. So let's pass in a width and a height as arguments to our scene constructor. So let's say 600 by 600. And the size of your stage is actually going to adjust to fit the size of the scene. You can see that our stage is no longer as wide as it was before. It's now a perfect square. You can also change the background color too. We'll pass in a color as an argument, color dot, and then you can pick a color from this list. I wonder if there's like a sky blue. Yeah, let's pick that. And now our scene should be a sky blue color. And if you adjust the size of your stage, the window, your scene is going to adjust in size as well too. If you need to disable that, just use the set resizable method of stages. Let's add some text to the scene. So we need to create a text object. Text equals new text. You can either pass in a string to the text constructor or you can use the set text method. So text dot then set text and we can pass in some text like whoa. All right. So since we're using a group root node, we need to manually place the coordinates of this object. So we'll set x and set y, text.setx, and let's set this to maybe 50. So this will be on the left side, and then we will set y to be 50 as well. So that will be near the top. So this should be in the top left corner. Text is a type of node, so we need to add this node to our root node, and our root node is already added to the scene. So before we set the scene and show the stage, let's add our text to our root node. So type in root, or whatever you're using for your root node, if it's named something else, dot get children, then add at the end, dot add whatever it is you want to add, whatever node. So we would like to add our text node. And when we run this program, we should have some text on our scene. Whoa, but you can't really see it because the font is kind of small, so let's change the font. So let's change a few other properties of our text node that we have. So after we set the x and y coordinates, let's change the font. Text.setFont, and you need to pass in a font as an argument. Font. And let's pick a font, maybe Verdana, and a size as well, maybe 50. And let's try this again. Yeah, that's much better. So let's also change the color as well, the fill color, text.setFill. And you pass in a paint object as an argument. So let's just say color dot maybe green. Wow, there's a lot of green colors. How about lime green? Let's take a look at that. Yeah, that's not too bad. So that's how to add text to your scene. Let's create a line. Line equals new line. A lot of these values I'm about to show you, you can pass into the line constructor, or there's various methods for setting them. So we need to set some starting coordinates as well as ending coordinates. So let's begin with the starting coordinates. Line dot set start x and then y. So where do we want this line to begin on the x-axis? Maybe where x is 200. So let's set y as well. Line dot set start y. Then we need an ending point for this line. Line dot set end x and then y. So I would like this line to end where x is 500. This will be a horizontal line. And we will set y to be 200. Line dot set end y 200. Now line is a node and we just need to add this node to our root node. So let's copy what we did for our text node and change text to line. And we should have a horizontal line on our scene. You also can change the stroke width as well as the stroke color. Let's begin by changing the stroke width. Line dot set stroke width. And pass in a new width, maybe 5. So this should be an extra thick line that we have. You can also change the color too. Line dot set stroke. And then pass in a paint object. Color dot maybe red. So this should be a red line. You can change the opacity. Line dot set opacity. So the opacity makes your object transparent. If I were to set this to 0.5, this will now be a transparent line. So this is on a scale with opacity between 0 and 1, I believe, too. So 0.5 would mean that this is like 50% transparent. You can also rotate this too using the set rotate method. Line dot set rotate. And let's pass in an amount of degrees like 45. And this will rotate our line 45 degrees. Now, these methods that I've shown you are only just a few. If you were to type in the name of your object, dot, if you have IntelliSense set up, you should have a huge comprehensive list of all the methods available to you to change some of these properties around for your object. I've only just covered a few, but there's still way more than this. Feel free to experiment and play around with some of those. Now, let's move on to rectangles. Rectangle, rectangle equals new rectangle. We need to set x and y. So type in the name of your rectangle. In my case, it's rectangle dot set x. I will set this to 100 and then set y. Set y to 100 as well, I suppose. So we can set a width and a height. So type in rectangle dot set width. I'll make this a square, so 100 by 100. And then rectangle dot set height. Set height, I will set this to 100. And then we need to add our rectangle to our root node. So I'll copy what I have here. Root dot get children dot add. I would like to add my rectangle. And we should have a rectangle on our scene. So this is just a black rectangle. We can change some of the properties around too. Let's change some of the properties of this rectangle, such as the color. Rectangle dot set fill, and we can pass in a color. Color dot maybe blue. Now this should be a blue rectangle. We can also add a border around this rectangle as well. So we can use set stroke width, and you can change the color too. So rectangle dot set stroke width. I'll set this to 5 to match the width of our line. You can also set the stroke color as well. Rectangle dot set stroke and pass in a color. Maybe I'll keep this as black. Color dot black. All right, let's take a look. And here is our rectangle, and we added a black border around our rectangle. Like I said, with a lot of these objects, you do have various properties and methods to change them. For example, with rectangles, there is a set opacity and set rotate method as well, although I've already shown that, so that would be kind of redundant. So feel free to experiment with some of those as well. Now let's move on to triangles. And to create a triangle, we actually need to use the polygon class, polygon, and let's call this triangle equals new polygon. As we know, triangles have 3 points. We need to add a set of coordinates for each point. So to do that, type in the name of your polygon. In this case, it is triangle dot get points. We'll do a little bit of method chaining at the end, add dot set all. This set all method takes double data types. All of our coordinates are going to be doubles. So after each coordinate, you can add 0.0, or you can do some casting too, either way. So let's say my first point is 200 by 200. And to make this more readable, I'm going to add each coordinate to a new line. It's not necessary, but it helps me read this. So these are the coordinates for my first point. And let's set the coordinates for the second point. 300.0 and 300.0 works. And the third point, 200.0 and 300.0. You can always change these around too. Let's change the color of this triangle. Triangle dot set fill and pick a color. I will pick yellow. And we need to add this triangle node, this polygon node, to our root node. At the end, root dot get children dot add triangle, and we should have a triangle on our scene. Let's move on to circles. Circle, circle equals new circle. When we set the location of our circle, we set center X and Y. This is where the center of our circle is going to appear. Set center X and then Y. So let's say 350 for X and the same for Y. Set center Y 350. We'll need to set a radius as well for the circle. So type in the name of your circle, dot set radius and pick a radius. I will pick 50. And we can set a fill color as well. Circle dot set fill and then pick a color. I think this time I'll pick orange, so it kind of resembles a basketball. And we need to add the circle node to our root node. Root.getChildren.addCircle. And we should have an orange circle on our scene. It's a basketball. Last but not least, we're going to add an image to our scene. I would like to add an image of a slice of pizza to my scene for some reason. So copy your file, and then go to your source folder, and then paste your image file. My image is called pizza.png. I'm going to create an image out of this file, so let's do that maybe here. Image, image, equals new, image. Then within the constructor of your image, list the file path or the file name. This is within my source folder, I only have to list the file name. If for some reason this doesn't work, you can always troubleshoot using the file path. So I'm going to go to properties, and you can copy the location. So if the following steps don't work for you, you can always troubleshoot and try the file path instead. Make sure this is within quotes though. But since this is within my source folder, I only need to list the file name. Now I need to create an image view object. Image view, and I will call this image view equals new image view, and pass in my image to the image view constructor. And we will set the coordinates of our image view. Image view dot set X. I'll set this to 400. And we will set Y as well. Image view dot set Y. I will keep that the same as 400. And we need to add this image view to our root node. So root.getChildren.add your image view. And now there should be a slice of pizza on my scene for some reason. I don't know why I decided that. Well, friends, that's the basics of scenes. It's a drawing surface for graphical content and a container for various nodes. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments section down below. But yeah, that is how scenes work in JavaFX. Hey you, yeah I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.